So hi everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. Alright, so let's begin with the session. And Wednesday ka session nahi ho paya tha due to certain technical reasons, but don't worry, unfortunately or fortunately there were not enough news to be covered in those days. Alright, so let's begin with the session. So aapka kuch bhi nahi chuta hai, so you guys don't have to worry about that. So if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed, and you can also ask your doubts here. You can also follow me here. Here also you can ask anything related to examinations, and anything related to examinations only. Faltu ki baatein yahan pe nahi hongi. Alright, so let's talk about the very first question, which says, consider the following statements with respect to International Intellectual Property Rights Index 2022, and you have to identify the correct statement. And I should not tell you that how much important this index is. Aur isme se question bhi bahut basic aayega, koi bahut zyada detail mein question aane wala nahi hai. Most probably the question will be from India's rank. All right, so let's talk about International Intellectual Property Index. So one second. Yes, so US Chamber of Commerce has released the International Intellectual Property Index of 2022, and this index has been released for evaluation of intellectual property rights across the global economies. Hamare desh mein jitni bhi badi badi economies hain, unka jo intellectual property rights ka kya scene hai, un sabko measure karta hai ye hamara index. And the total number of countries which have been evaluated is 55, and the total number of parameters in this index, guys, is 50. Just remember that there are 50 indicators or parameters. You do not have to learn the names of all the indicators. That is not important for exam. Okay. Top three countries are USA, UK and Germany. And as I already told you that top three countries ab yaad karna zaruri ho gaya hai, because in various examination they are asking top five also. Top five tak question ja raha hai. But I believe ki RBI se bhi NABARD abhi unka dimag itna kharab nahi hua hai ki wo top five tak pahunche. So abhi unka top three tak hi hai. So you have to remember the top three countries, USA, UK and Germany. Alright. Now what about India? What is the position of India in this particular index? So India's score is 38.64%. Overall ranking is 43 out of 55 countries. And among all the Asian countries, India's rank is 12th. And among all the Asian nations, Japan is ranked number 1. Japan jo hai wo number 1 pe hai among all the Asian countries. While among all the Asian countries, India is at rank 12. However, overall ranking is 43. So this is very important. Overall ranking yaad rakhna is very, very important, and the score, of course, that is 38.64%. So now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement. The index has been released by World Trade Organization. No, it has been released by US Chamber of Commerce. So this is incorrect. India has been ranked at 43 out of 55 global economies. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And USA has topped the index. So ye bhi baat bilkul sahi hai, which means only 2 and 3 should be the correct answer, which is option C. Option C, only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. Now let's talk about question number 2. Consider the following statements with respect to Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Janaushadhi Pariyojana, and you have to identify the correct statement. So first of all, is that a new scheme? Of course not. It is not a new scheme. You must have heard about this particular pariyojana, this particular yojana. So the question is, why we are discussing about it? Why is it in news? So remember, it is in news because Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizer has launched Jan Aushadhi Rath, Jan Aushadhi Mobile App and Jan Aushadhi e-rickshaws across the country. Teen cheez launch hui hai, Jan Aushadhi Rath, Jan Aushadhi Mobile App and Jan Aushadhi e-riksha. Now, what is the objective of launching all these things? This is for raising awareness at the grassroots level about the benefits of Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Janaushadhi Pariyojana and the benefits of Janaushadhi Generic Medicines. Jo Janaushadhi Generic Medicines distribute ki jati hai under this Pariyojana, uske benefit batane ke liye, and also to raise awareness about the overall benefits of this scheme, these things have been launched. Alright. Now, since it is in news, the Pariyojana is in news, so that's why it is our duty to discuss about this. So what is the objective of this particular scheme? So it is for extending the coverage of generic medicine. Extending the coverage of क्वालिटी जेनरेट मेडिसिन, जो हमारे क्वालिटी जेनरेट मेडिसिन है उसके कवरेज को एक्सटेंड करना, सो एज टू रिड्यूस द आउट ऑफ पॉकेट एक्सपेंडिचर ऑन मेडिसिन, जो हमारे मेडिसिन के ऊपर आउट ऑफ पॉकेट एक्सपेंडिचर है उसको कम करना. इट वॉज लॉन्च इन 2008, बट डू रिमेंबर इट वॉज रिवाम्प्ड इन द ईयर 2015-16, विच मीन्स द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2016. इट वॉज लॉन्च इन 2008, बट इट वॉज रिवाम्प्ड इन द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2016. And please do not get confused. It is not being implemented by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Because ऐसा होता है कि medicine का जिक्र होते ही आपका दिमाग जाएगा Ministry of Health पे. But it is not like that. It is being implemented by Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers through Bureau of Pharma PSUs of India. Which means Bureau of Pharma PSUs of India is the implementing agency. Alright? And remember, very recently, the government has set the target that they will establish 10,000 Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Janaushadhi Kendras by the month of March in the year 2024. And this will be easily, this target will be easily achieved because around 8,500 Aushadhi Kendras have already been established. Alright. So now let's come back to the question. You have to identify correct statement with respect to this scheme. It was launched in 2008. Yes, this is absolutely correct. 10,000 PM Janaushadhi Kendras will be opened by 2024. Bilkul sahi baat hai. And it is being implemented by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Is that so? No. It is being implemented by Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers, which is headed by Mr. Mansukh Mandavia. Alright. So, 1 and 2 should be the correct answer. Option A. Option A, only 1 and 2 will be the correct answer. Now moving ahead to question number 3. Very direct question and very easy question. Name the program launched by Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying, which is headed by Mr. Purushottam Rupala, in the honor of great freedom fighters, sailors and fishers. So everything is already provided in the question. There is a program which has been launched by the Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying. Why this program has been launched? This is for honoring the great freedom fighters, the sailors and the fishermen of the country. ठीक है, सो यही न्यूज है. एंड द नेम ऑफ द प्रोग्राम इज सागर परिक्रमा. सागर परिक्रमा, राइट? सो एंड विच मिनिस्ट्री हैज लॉन्च्ड? मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फिशरीज, एनिमल हस्बेंड्री एंड डेयरिंग. रिमेंबर दिस प्रोग्राम हैज बीन स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम गुजरात. इट हैज ऑलरेडी बिगन फ्रॉम गुजरात एंड अ सी वोएज विल बी डन कवरिंग ऑल द कोस्टल स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज ऑफ द कंट्री स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम गुजरात. गुजरात से एक सी वोएज स्टार्ट होगा जो कि हमारे सारे कोस्टल स्टेट्स और यूटीज को कवर करता हुआ जाएगा. ऑलराइट, सो इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा डिटेल में जाने की जरूरत नहीं है. इन दिस पर्टिकुलर न्यूज यू डू नॉट हैव टू गो इनटू मोर डिटेल्स. ऑलराइट, सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट? सागर परिक्रमा. वंस अगेन, ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर, सागर परिक्रमा. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, विच इज अगेन बेस्ड ऑन अ स्कीम. व्हाट इज द टोटल आउटले ऑफ एक्सटेंडेड पीरियड ऑफ अम्ब्रेला स्कीम रिलीफ एंड रिहैबिलिटेशन ऑफ माइग्रेंट्स एंड रिपैट्रिएट्स. एक ये स्कीम है, दिस इज एन अम्ब्रेला स्कीम एंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर अम्ब्रेला स्कीम देर आर 7 सब स्कीम्स. ठीक है, एंड दिस इज इन न्यूज बिकॉज इट हैज बीन कंटिन्यूड फॉर अ पीरियड स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम दिस फाइनेंशियल ईयर, दैट इज फाइनेंशियल ईयर 22 अप टू फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2026. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द न्यूज देन. दिस इज द न्यूज. यूनियन कैबिनेट हैज अप्रूव्ड द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ 7 एग्जिस्टिंग सब स्कीम्स अंडर दिस अम्ब्रेला स्कीम ऑफ रिलीफ एंड रिहैबिलिटेशन of migrants and repatriates and for a period of financial year 2022 to financial year 2026. And remember, for the extended period, jo extended period hai uske liye total outlay kitna hai? ₹1452 crores. ₹1452 crores is the total outlay for the extended periods. Alright. Now this scheme, guys, is not so much important and therefore we do not have to go into the details. I will tell you the list of those 7 sub schemes which are working under this particular scheme, but that also wo bhi aapko yaad rakhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai. You don't have to remember all these 7 sub schemes, just read it once, that is more than enough. So number 1 is relief and rehabilitation of displaced families of Pakistan occupied areas of Jammu and Kashmir and Cham. Number 2, relief assistance to Sri Lankan Tamil refugees. So you must have heard of that LTT story. श्रीलंकन तमिल रिफ्यूजीज को रिलीफ देना इज वन ऑफ द सब स्कीम. Number 3, रिलीफ असिस्टेंस टू ब्रूज लॉस्ड इन रिलीफ कैंप्स इन त्रिपुरा. ब्रूज इज अ स्पेशल ट्राइब ऑफ त्रिपुरा एंड दे आर ऑल्सो फाइंड इन सम पार्ट्स ऑफ सदर्न असम. enhanced relief to 1984 anti-Sikh riot victims, financial assistance and other facilities to the families of affected civilian victims of terrorist violence. Number 6, grant in aid to Central Tibetan Relief Committee. And finally, number 7, grant in aid to Government of West Bengal for infrastructure development in 51 erstwhile Bangladeshi enclaves in India. जो पहले बांग्लादेशी इनक्लेव्स थे इंडिया में, जो कि 2015 में इंडिया में शामिल हुए हैं, वहां पे इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट के लिए ग्रांट इन एड इज बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड टू द वेस्ट बंगाल गवर्नमेंट बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया अंडर दिस 7th सब स्कीम. ऑलराइट, सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. देन यू जस्ट हैव टू टेल द टोटल आउटले ऑफ एक्सटेंडेड पीरियड, दैट इज हाउ मच रुपीज 1452 क्रोर्स. ऑप्शन ई विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. नाउ लेट्स मूव अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. Question number 5 says, which of the following agencies has organized the Tech Conclave 2022, which has been organized for knowledge sharing in the field of technology? So you just have to tell the name of the organizer. And of course, in such type of news, in such type of conclave, webinar, seminar, you do not have to go into the details unless it is very much important. ठीक है? कोई अगर बहुत ज़्यादा important है, like for example, if it is Def Expo, then you have to go into the details. At least आपको उसका theme तो करना ही पड़ेगा. But in such type of conclave, you don't have to go into the details. Just remember which ministry or which organization has organized it. All right. So it has been organized by NIC, National Informatics Center, and this should be CDAC. National Informatics Center has organized, and this works of course under Ministry of Electronics and IT, which is headed by Mr. Ashwini Vaishnav. And now the last question for today, question number 6. With which of the following companies, Solar Energy Corporation of India Limited has signed an MOU to realize green energy objectives of Government of India and to make India a carbon neutral economy. So as hope you all know that the Prime Minister of India has announced that India is going to be a carbon neutral economy by the year 2070, and it was announced during COP26. All right. Now can you tell me that where will COP27 held? COP27 कहाँ पे होगा बता सकते हो? Let me tell you the name of the country, Egypt. It will be held in Egypt. Now you have to tell me the name of place जहाँ पे ये होगा. Alright, so this MOU remember has been signed with Hindustan Petroleum. Again, in such MOU type of question, I have already told you. Just remember the name of the organizations or the countries or the PSUs between which the MOU has been signed and the purpose. That's it. इससे ज़्यादा करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. So here this MOU has been signed between Hindustan Petroleum and SECI, which is Solar Energy Corporation of India Limited. And what is the objective? To realize green energy objective of the Government of India. Alright, so option B, Hindustan Petroleum, is the correct answer. So that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. So I'll see you in the next session on Monday. Goodbye, take care and God bless.